predictable. I'm not gonna say no kills. This is going to be pretty light by whole big on this occasion. And Lucky just bringing with this. I was kind of reluctant there.
Yeah.
With the rest and the spike in your hand so close. Take more care. The rotations are in, but look at Hive on B.
Yeah, again.
Yeah. He was like, oh, I left something here from last round, so let's see if I can find it on the floor. It was... Okay, that's the first one. But yeah, all the stuff is being created, and yeah, this is going to be...
Yeah, they're taking them down one by one, bit by bit. And at that point in time, it should be pretty much invested.
Okay.
And still, Bishop finds a decent frag, don't get me wrong. That's proper stuff. That miracle won't be granted. They're forcing them back and away from their advantageous position. AslaN suddenly gone, the operator worth 4,700 credits. Eliminated, and kAdavra just goes on. Just juseu is with it as well, and this combination of duelists is just damn lethal. Where's the reply big? Can't see it. Alex, after finding one once more AslaN type performance, popping some heads, collecting some dog tags. There you start, kAdavra out, but obviously don't take a look too close into it, because otherwise you will fall. Even the revive coming in, most likely to really build up that economy. You see, 9k and more tank accounts.
Maybe you can start a fund, you know, for your retirement. Okay, and Juseu is just going for the... he's going for the ace, but, you know, Hype is always gonna give some info.
There you go. Finally. That's the start you need.
Things, I mean, it's to prevent the plant, so maybe... onto yellow, maybe it ended up being... Oh!
It's just getting worse.
Still, it's a 4v10, and they have the rest. They should take this easily.
And they're just, at that point in time...
Oh no.
Getting wrecked. Totally polarized here, big, and... Surely it's a 2v2, surely it's somewhat possible, but... Alliance on the back foot, suddenly turn things around. Bishop is looking to get that defuse going. Very eager from Hype, and Bishop's gonna be sick. No, he's not even halving it. He didn't put this thing onto the half, and so he can't defuse it in the end. Juseu might be eliminated, but is there enough time? No, he would have halved.
And you chose to start defending.
Indeed. I was quickly talking with the German lad casting his super buddy, and I told him I don't see Alliance not winning this. There's no universe that Big prevails. No disrespect to Big, but I don't see it happening. It's just a different sort of caliber, and Big made amazing progress. Really, I think they're one of the teams where
on the way across the map. See if Obnoks here can make a win and play.
Oh, good discipline, good timing. Oh no,
wow,
the wall's up.
Wall.
It's amazing.
And the same.
They're suddenly stuck, blocking each other. The coordination is missing, really. And the Bishop just dodging a bit of the Hunter's Fury. Maybe it's still possible. Big.
It is.
To potentially just find another frack. But as I say that, AslaN falls. A. That's an operator once more laying in the snow and becoming ice cold. But Gops on point. The triple is secure. All right. Alliance only got Fearoth at this point. But don't say that it's only Fearoth. One of the players that I really highlighted the last time around, as he really had high impact for the more support type of agent he plays, can dodge the dart in time. And this could be misleading for Big. They might just have a different interpretation of what is happening, as Bishop has now been spotted. Shots have come in early.
This is enough money to buy the two last rounds.
Oh, there you go. Another one of those. Big. Oh, and yeah, Bishop, just the second he drops, has been hurt. AslaN is whiffing. Juseu is immediately joining to kill Obnoks, and the slaughter has begun. Alliance is in the driver's seat again. One single round they have lost, even on full force they suddenly are. And the prerequisite kind of skill or for overall cohesion is just missing. Gops are taking his time. Again, one player found, but he didn't see the second around the corner. Just unlucky. He was going for luck. And here's the thing, let us remember, Kakuka, that it was Big struggling but massively in the defense against Finest, who were actually flourishing when they were attacking. And for now, the spike's down, that's great, they're backing off. Bishop and his boys hardly have any chance. Gop's trying, but there you go. Juseu, they will somehow make it possible. I mean, surely they obtained side control, but this doesn't have to mean a thing. The Eris being something players seem to like recently much more, and it's more common. Seemingly Alliance might just struggle, or the pocket round came out of big. Well, those tiny little weaponry, they have
forced.
And you might be right, and my eyes have been actually lying, and well, my brain probably did too, but juseu
is... I mean, I can be wrong as
well. No worries, well, it's only down to two more on the big side of things, and AslaN is being one of the two. Got his little marshal out, and alex also tries to secure that round in favor of his team. There's no snake fight, and suddenly Hype is just taking the elevator up to alex. Can he make it in time? Nope, it doesn't seem to be the case. And I have to be honest, just you'll find that. Getting away from that topic, you know, I was all big, good old German fan expectations. Hold on, how did he get hyped there? Phenomenal kill from AslaN and Alliance. They're split up. Obnoks finding another, and here you go. This is the same way that we saw those guys from big play against Finest. They didn't find a thing when they were defense, but their attack looked decent. And maybe this is something where they can once more bring us around number 5. There wouldn't be juseu. Oh, 5 points of health, they'll make it easier. He needs to swing with a pre-fire, but alex got him already locked in his...
A drone, they're gonna be waiting for someone to pick, but no. See if they can stop this, because we have seen big doing this, and the result was pretty much like here. This one. Locking sight. Oh, we didn't manage to find... to land the first one.
Nope. And Hype is going back out. Let me go back to my tent. Quick! Goes up again. Smoke integrity filled up, but as juseu swings wide, Alliance might just have an ace up their sleeve. But, well, as I say that...
Yeah, they need to save.
Absolutely.
You see that?
Maybe I was just stretching my mouth. Or alternatively, I was actually not saying anything. You can choose whatever story you like more. Well, luckeRRR, though... He's definitely liking the story of getting this one finally done and dusted, and with Obnoks falling on the ground, it could be easily that, but you see what is awaiting them. This is obviously a Gobby who would still have a Hunter's Fury if he likes to, and he's taking an aggressive route. Back off, Gob, back off. He does exactly that. Of course Gob does that. Now he's waiting for it, and here it comes. Is dapr sticking it? Nope, he can't afford it. Oh, this is so smart from Gob!
Because previous round in this one, that's the second one that he got to get for his team.
And AslaN is being eliminated. juseu backs off right there. And it is the big side of things that have a slight man advantage, but things can turn around easily. And though, as I say that...
Be awesome. Oh, man, oh, we're back in the game. I almost forgot that we're still here after that, and this is bad. No rest for Alliance after their timeout, and they've obviously had to talk about, okay, what happened? What happened those 7 rounds?
So why did your snake bite not land? What the hell? But
if they wanted the explanation.
If they rewatch that, I can't believe that they imagine this would be something where you lose a round off. I would be so mad, but nevertheless, big 2 rounds away, and you saw what kind of disastrous state they were in. 2-10, I think, end of the half.
And with Bishop he did see him.
Yeah, Bishop having an unlucky timing. It might just be finally number 12, but still a little pocket round.
Well, it's a pocket round, but kAdavra, I feel like he's playing with the operator.
I'm taking it back.
That pressure. Yeah. Yeah.
My bad.
Yeah, and juseu here. He's back. He's completely protected. He can just play with the operator. Alex here. Danger. That is a big word. That is the word that you need.
No, Alex, please don't give me this. No. For Christ's sake, Alex has to give us a heart attack. And why, Alex, do you have to do that? Just chill. No. You could have had it. And Gop is just pressing nothing else than DNA at the same time. Came from the shot, and big might just be done and dusted. Oh, I'm taking it back. It's this good old AslaN who's going for it, and he's sticking. This could be the clutch of a lifetime from AslaN. He knows one is around the corner. He's going to reload, and he has the daggers out. It's now his time. The prodigy from Germany starts off good. He's taking off the chest of Fearoth. It could be another one coming in from here, and that is perfect stuff from AslaN so far. But is it the gladiator big was looking for? Is it the final frack he gets? No! It's kAdavra finding it! Number 12 and closer
to- and just got one of the daggers, so yeah, that green box was just in the way of the 10th for big. And oh man, that was such a nice streak. Still, they're not out. They do have to save the next 3 rounds, but they're doing a great job. they shouldn't be into that. I mean, of course, there's a lot of pressure. Ooh. Wait for the rest. Oh no. The power of a tactical pause.
I can't believe it, man. I genuinely, this is... Alex whiffing was the first one where we got... He's gonna hate himself for that. I'm... Again, once more, also sorry for him. You hate to see that that happens. Still. Besides that point. Big. Now need free flawless round.
Yeah, Kadavra's just stronghold in here. This operator is gonna spot I thought he was just gonna spot it. And I bet Alex just stopped the same as I did.
He's back alive at least, and AslaN is hungry, but kAdavra is just right now farming. He's thanking them for those frags. Big stand a chance, but they gotta make some work with a major man disadvantage. Only down to three they are, and luckeRRR just goes on and on, but Alex has picked up the operator, and he just might find the success they need, but it doesn't seem to be the case. Scott will try too many enemies around him, and kAdavra, oh man, his vision is blocked. Same goes for his teammates, and Fearoth. Can he just bail out? Nope, no chance. Obnoks is even finding him. Once more, the defense seems somewhat weakened over on the side of B, but how much can Hype do? He has been an absolute master over on Icebox, but first of all, he's being beheaded. High ground though used by juseu. We're getting back into a back and forth. At least this is what it seems like for now.
Yeah, and this is 3-3 situation. The spike has just been planted. Don't give too much room. Both sage walls. There's not going to be anyone pushing through stairs. There's three. Still alive on site.
Here it is. Destroying the wall. They want to get in there, finally. As the spike has to be obviously defused. Get that damn thing out of the way. juseu starts good, but Obnoks is eliminating him in the process. They both come from the same corner. AslaN is low HP, and he's not hitting his shots initially. This is unfortunate for him. If he would have probably got Omen that early on, could have been easy. He might just have one to his left in sight, near to the flower pot. And look at that patience.
I mean, the martial shots are definitely scary. I don't know if they're going to be... Oh, expecting things, but it's not enough.
Backing off for a very good reason. AslaN though, low HP. That could obviously end dramatic for his team. He's gonna go a little further towards hell and is beheaded. None of that worked in the end, but Obnoks and Alex still continue to rise. juseu is still on it, and he wants a rifle. He's having a bit of the edge of the body coming out of the smoke. So at the drawing board, Big is taking a look once more. What kind of attack did they have planned? Well, definitely that was not according to plan. Timing is so unfortunate for luckeRRR, but the reinforcements already arrived. Fearoth just waits to make it work together with Hype, but they get none. Still, they bought a little bit of time with the Nano Swarm, but look on the minimap tells Kuku somewhat of an... could be coming an inside joke at Big, but Bishop recklessly going first. Nobody had short control.
What alliance. What kAdavra has definitely got the headshots in the aim. Ooh. Obnoks just feeling the rain inside of him a little bit. Look at all that pressure on mid. They're going to manage to find another kill.
kAdavra's back in it. And Big, with only two soldiers remaining. Hardly any opportunities to actually take this home in their favor. Or do they? Well, okay. Alex is not asking for a haircut again. 60 HP on Obnoks, which is nice and great that you get the spike down. And they're taking a lot of time. I didn't expect that. kAdavra's not eliminated. At least he gets juseu. Makes it a...
Give up this round and think of the next one. You can use that wall.
There you go.
Yeah, what's coming from CT, but juseu here.
They're just lining up for him. Just wanted to say, this can't be working that easy. juseu is pretty much on point. The guy is just purely...
Giving him a little bit of smoke. Luck is just waiting for his team. Oh... Why would you show yourself? To use it.
I don't know. I genuinely don't know. Fearoth though. It's gonna be a free track, isn't it? No. Bishop just dumped. There you go. See you later, Bishop. Oh, unlucky. And AslaN. I mean, Big are losing their key components in this. 100%. And sure, Alliance, only four on the server, but the way they hold things so far and the way they are on point, it still feels for me like Lions has a slight advantage when it comes down to pure skill, to pure... I have to say. That's Nate going deep, and juseu trying to hold it up. And no way that they don't know about AslaN. I can't believe that they are having no awareness about AslaN, but in the meantime, Gops taking a lot of them into a very broad situation. Nevertheless, still a many quiet scenario. Obnoks flash might just open up a new opportunity, and that seems to be the case. Lions, they're exactly only down to one, and the Taipu definitely has second thoughts on that ult, because primarily, he needs kills.
He needs kills, and the spike is gonna go down, so... See if he can manage to find any of those. He manages to find... Oh my god.
Oh, no.
You said it. If there's someone who can do it, it's Hype.
And it is Hype. And he's keeping up the Hype. He saw him. And now he even got his little turret out. If I don't see it correctly...
Use the lockdown.
Just wanted to say, we use the lockdown. It's the first thing.
Nicole.
And then it might be just the right dart. Gop has to make a move and a decision. He's gotta be spotted, but he eliminates him. It's a lot of pin control, but they allow it. Because it seems like they have the exact antidote to that. You feel No way! The timing is unreal! The timing of this is just unreal! I mean, the shot on Gop, sure, let him have that. But suddenly someone pops up behind him.
Wow.
He must have been like, wait, hold on. I got a second? Where did the second one come from? It's just not believable. But at the end of the day, this is what I mean. It's just sometimes big is an unlucky scenario. Because this is damn unlucky. It's just, it's nothing that I would relate necessarily to skill. Sure, the first one was, but the second one, pure luck. No disrespect, mate.
Juseu just wanted to go for the kill, and maybe he shouldn't have. This is still 1v3, and it's gonna be pretty tough. It's not gonna be spotted, but I already have that kind of information. Yeah, he does have no time, really.
10 seconds left.
You can try, but Kadavra's gonna spot him right away.
Oh? Oh? What did you say?
Oh?
Aww.
Aww.
There you go.
Aww.
It's those times are dark, but initially, it's a little bit of a wall coming up. They want to go over short again, but no opportunity.
I also feel like, I'll tell you about it later after this round, but Kadavra, I mean, Kadavra really wants to know what I have to say because he's already got two.
It's just getting worse again. There you go.
Yeah. This last round is already a mess for Big. Using all that abilities, spike, but the spike is going to fall. Side. And not much else to do. I was going to tell you that they did manage to beat Liquid, yada yada. They did manage to lose the last encounter here on this map. And probably that is one of the key factors. Butter. I would have like a different tone. Butter.
In the meantime,
I like how butter sounds, like butter.
So, whilst the viewers are enjoying our discussion how butter should be pronounced, all good, should be pronounced, it well seems like Big are struggling after they got a great kill with the shotgun initially, and the damage Scott does!
Wow!
Great opportunism by him, but it's, hold on, that was actually for the wall! I've never seen such a wallbang happen, and Big are still in a decent spot, specifically considering the damage that has been dealt on two of the three remaining players. Right click's coming in, and it's AslaN who finished it off. So,
I mean,
what was your bread and butter? Suppressing fire from AslaN seems to work quite decently, actually, when it comes down to those shots from short to connector. kAdavra, a little too greedy with that move as he was trying to get someone for the smoke. A second star is still ready from Alex. So, trespassing over A main seems impossible for the moment, and god damn it. No, he was, you see where he's standing, right?
Yes.
You see that he's standing on the B side and got that shock dart kill all over the map. This is the quality of Gop. I don't want to know how many hours he already spent on just finding something with his darts.
And now he's pumped. Obviously he is. You know what happened previous round, and now this. That is... Pull out with exactly what you need, a win, and now...
Course. Just talking about it, I think he forgot his responsibility towards short. As AslaN and Alex will finally get the kills, those are easy gifts coming in. And they want those rounds desperately, right? This was a pocket round, and they still used their ult.
Yeah, of course, the difference is still there, so... I'm gonna try and do something about it, but yeah. Even though they're gonna get the plant, I'm not entirely sure. Gonna be able to get something else. Oh!
There you go. Good start. Double shock dart, by the way, available. And that just might hold them up a little longer. Bishop is tagged quite brutally, to be accurate. Juseu, though, has to be taken out. And here he goes. We're suddenly in a man equalized scenario. AslaN drop, and AslaN is out. It could be the clutch coming in. And it is really one of those rounds.
Oh, no.
It's basically the key. It is the key to success. The linchpin for the future of Big. Because otherwise, Alliance might be just running away with it. And it seems for the moment, Big's in a driver's seat of round number 17.
30 seconds left.
Only one man. That's high. Can he get much more? Nope. Peeking into too many. Big's back.
How many kills? Ain't about the pockets rounds anymore, but AslaN does have the operator right now. Oh no. Oh no.
There you go. Good job, Kuka. Thanks.
This is the thing. They just don't have to buy if they want to win. It's three more rounds to close this, but... Oh no.
No! This is the point. You think this could be done and dusted? Because he had the clearest kill, and with Alex going on, it might have just been already success for Big, but no way.
Wow.
Big pretty much shattered at this point. And you have to say...
A main. Let's put Thera. The attack is imminent onto B.
And they're fast. kAdavra is still having his little rocket launcher out, which then means an easy frag on Bishop is coming in. He determined it. AslaN's losing his head. And the 12-7 is inevitable. It's the same as on Icebox. At one point, they just turned the map.
Movement was just perfect. I mean, Alliance did not have much to say in that situation. They did play it very nicely. It was risky, of course, but they did take out the Hunter's Fury and also the Resurrection from them. So this is not looking too bad. I mean, of course, it could be gone any single round, but I have to say, they do stand their chances.
Unusual, you could say. Cover going out. Really in that expression, but at least it is Fearoth. We can make something work, but Obnoks was the double. AslaN also coming in. It's once more 2v2, and things turn around massively fast. There's no revive on anyone, so no resurrection that can be used. AslaN's timing, though, Kakuka. AslaN's timing... his play, where he's on his own, he can't afford to make a mistake. AslaN, please turn around, make it work, and he can! Finds one, the second is not granted, it's Sage versus Sage, and Bishop is patiently waiting to find it, but it's no peek from juseu. He's playing it smart, he's playing with your mind, and you don't think he would come close to you, but he's backing off. Left. Bishop knows there's a spike to defuse.
Spike planted.
Smart movement.
Absolutely. And when is it coming? It doesn't come. It's Big!